Hi there, this is Akrich. So this video is going to be walkthrough of Kayoptrix level 4 box, which is considered to be easy box. So let's get started. So let's first run the nmap scan to find out what are the port is open on this box. So let's say sudo nmap hyphen sc to run the vulnerable script, hyphen sv to scan for a version information of the service, hyphen o to find out the operating system, hyphen p hyphen 2 scan for all the port and IP address of the server. So looking into nmap scan, we have four port open. So first one is port 22, which is SSH service. Second one is port 80, which is HTTP service. And we also have the Apache version information. So we can search in the search flight, is there any vulnerability exists for this version? And the last one is Samba service. So let's first enumerate the Samba service. So let's list out all the share present in the SMB service as an anonymous user using SMB client tool, SMB client hyphen L and the IP address of the server. Hit enter, hit enter. So we have a two share, one is print and another one is IPC, which is default share. So we don't have any interesting shares here. So let's move to enumeration of HTTP service. So coming to enumeration of HTTP service, so here because we have the version information of Apache service, so let's look in the search Floyd. Is there any vulnerability exists for this particular Apache version? So copy this, search Floyd. Yeah, this is the version, hit enter. So here the first one is Apache plus PHP. PHP should be less than 5.3. So if you look at here, it is 5.2, and which is vulnerable to remote code execution. So the server is most likely vulnerable to this vulnerability. So let's check whether we can exploit this vulnerability or not. So this is the exploit. Let's copy this path, say search exploit hyphen m, paste this. So now this exploit will be copied to desktop folder. Okay, if I say ls hyphen l, which is 29, yeah, we have that exploit in this current folder. Okay, so let's look into that exploit. So you can read about the exploit, and here you can see how to compile this binary file. Copy this command, exit. So the name of the file is not this, it is 29, and let's name it to exploit. So now we have compiled the binary. So let's run that exploit. So here you can see the usage of this binary. You have to specify the target and the port number and the protocol and the reverse IP address, which is our IP address, and reverse port. So in order to execute this exploit, we need to host the netcat listener. Let's listen to this port. So let's say target is server IP address, which is 10.0.2.13, and the port number is 80, and the protocol is HTTP, right? And reverse IP address is our IP address. Let's find out our IP address. If config 10.0.2.15, and the reverse port number is this, right? This is the port we are listening. So hit enter. Okay. So did we get any shell? No, that means this exploit didn't work. So if you look into the result, what happened is this exploit tried to look for this directory in the web server, but we got the 404 error. That means that directory is not found. So here it tried again. This is also not found. Here also we got 404 error. Yeah. So that means this exploit didn't work. So let's look into the website, what we have in the website 10.0.2.13. Okay, we have the login page. So let's look into the source code. So nothing interesting. Okay, let's try for admin. No, wrong username and password. Okay, fine. Let's brute force the directory using ferox fster. Say ferox fster hyphen u to specify the URL, hyphen w to specify the word list, user share word list dir common.txt. Hyphen x to specify the file extension, PHP and HTML. Hit enter. So let's go to this login page. So whenever we see the login page, it is tempting to put SQLi payload. Let's try the SQL injection. Admin. Put the single quote in both username field and password field. Let's see whether we are getting any SQL error or not. And we got an SQL error. That means this login page is most likely vulnerable to SQL injection. Let's check whether we are getting the SQL error because of the single quote present in the username field or password field. So let's put a random character in password field. Login. So we didn't get any error. That means it is because of the password field. So password field is vulnerable to SQL injection. Let's put the SQLi payload in this password field. So I'm going to use this payload. Login. Yeah, we successfully logged in as an admin user, but we didn't get any useful stuff here. If you look at the URL, you can play with this username parameter. You can brute force the username and check whether we are getting any useful stuff. So let's go back to Ferox Fster. Okay, here this is 200. This is the home page. Fine. 301. Image is fine. Index is also fine. Index. Yeah, there is John directory. Let's copy this. So there is a John.php. Oh. So we have a username and password for a John user. We can try this credential on every service because user is tempting to reuse the password. So let's first check on Samba service. Let's use SMB client. Hyphen u to specify the username. John. Hit enter. Yes. So no, we didn't get any interesting share here. So let's check this credential on SSH service. So SSH John 10.2. So we have an error related to key. So in order to fix this error, you have to use this flag, hit enter and copy this password, paste it here. So we got a shell, but it is restricted shell. If I say help, we can only execute these commands. So there is a way to escape from this restricted shell using echo command. You can say echo os.system and /bin/sh, or you can say /bin/. Yeah. So we successfully escaped from this restricted shell. Now we can execute any command. So let's hop over to website directory to check whether we missed anything. in the website var www ls fill. So this was the file which is responsible for to check the valid credential, right? So let's check the source code of this PHP file, because in order to check the valid credential, it need to connect to database, right? So let's check the source code of this file. So if you look at here, yeah, username is root and password is empty. So we can connect to MySQL database as a root user. So let's say MySQL hyphen u root user hyphen p enter. Yeah, we got access to database. We can execute the command as a root user, right? So select this exec. So I will add the John user to admin group. So user mode hyphen a hyphen g admin, username is John. So hit enter whether we can execute this select statement successfully or not. Yeah, we are able to execute this command. That means this John user now added to admin group. So let's exit from this MySQL database. So now if I say sudo su, we should get a root shell. So su, John password is this. Yes, we have the root privilege now. So we successfully found this box. So that is all for this video. Until then, stay tuned, like the video and subscribe the channel.